Hey guys, it's Kayla here. Welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to do a little bit of a bookshelf tour. I just recently organized my shelves in the background. You can't tell. There's lots of open space because I wanted that on purpose so I can get more books and expand my collection. But anyways, I'm gonna do a bookshelf tour. So yeah, hope you guys like it.
First, I'm gonna do like a little bit of a pan of what my bookshelves look like. So this is kind of like where in my head, like it starts, is this big long one. Okay. And then these three short ones. And then my big other long one. So we will start up here. Okay. So I have them all spaced out because it took me forever to figure out how I wanted them separated. And I figured out that I wanted them separated by genre. So my very top shelf is my mystery and thriller and horror and suspense and all that stuff. So I've got House of Leaves by Mark Danielewski, something like that. Dan Brown stuff, some Sherlock Holmes stuff, Agatha Christie, The Good House by Tanan Rivedu, so good. Murderous Schemes, which is from a class I had to take in college, and Dark Places by Gillian Flynn, which I really loved. So that's my mystery thriller lonely shelf. There's a lot more room for some good ones, so there's that. All right, the next one is my poetry / plays one. So I have this big treasury book of poems, which I love. I got this at Barnes & Noble like a gazillion years ago, and I still love it. I've still found a lot of my favorite poems in here, so I have that, and I got it so cheap. Then I have my Edgar Allan Poe Complete Tales and Poems. I love this book. I love Edgar Allan Poe. He's my guy. And yeah, so it has all of his poems and short stories and stuff like that. So I love it. I still need to read a lot of it. I have the complete works of William Shakespeare. A friend of mine gave me this a few years ago and I love it. It has all of it. Also on this edge is the Analecta 2012. It was my college's literary journal. I had a poem that was published in this journal, and that's why I have so many copies. I was gonna send them to my uncles and aunts, but I never did, so whoops. And then A New Views on Gender. This was also from my college. I helped edit. I was an editor on this, so there's that. And then this, I think I had to read this for school. This was a required reading, so Indiana Review. So yeah, so that's what that stuff is. And then this is all my Shakespeare stuff. And I took a Shakespeare class in college, which is why I have all of this. I have Romeo and Juliet because I loved Romeo and Juliet. And then these were all required. So I had to get all of these. And then this, which is the Bedford Companion to Shakespeare, which was really helpful in like understanding Shakespeare. And it was just, yeah, I like it. So that's that. And then these are my collections of poems. So I have Howl by Allen Ginsberg, which I think is just one poem. It's just super long, pretty sure. This I also had in a class. It's called Music Spell, Poems About Music and Musicians. This was for our class. So some poems in there. Our Town, which is a play. I was in this play when I was a senior in high school. And yeah, so that's why I have that. The Song of Hiawatha, which is by Henry Wadsworth Longfellow, which I'm pretty sure is just one giant long poem that I had to read for my first year when I went to Purdue. This Around Uluru is a collection of poems by Nicholas Kurtovich. The Plath Cabinet, which I don't think any of these are by Sylvia Plath, but they're by Katherine Bowman, and they're all like inspired by Sylvia Plath. This is one of my favorite collections of poetry. This is called Words for Empty and Words for Full by Bob Hickok. I met him in person. He came and spoke at Purdue University when I first went there. Bob Hickok is a professor at Virginia Tech, and he was one of the professors of the guy that did the Virginia Tech shooting. And so he has a couple of poems in here that are about that, and it's really sad, but it was cool to meet him in person. And yeah, these are like, they were like textbooks I had to have. They're all poetry, but there's a lot. This is my favorite one. I think I have quite a bit of stuff written in here and like highlighted and stuff. Again, this was from Purdue, but that's one of my favorites. And then just some like essays and like short stories, stuff like that. So that's that. Okay, so this next shelf below is my YA romance, which is why it's so little. I have the Twilight series. I've read a lot of Sarah Dessen, but for some reason I only have one of her books, which I didn't know. And then The Sky is Everywhere by Jandy Nelson, which I loved. I read that like, God, how many years ago? Like 8 years ago. So that's that. I doubt I'll probably buy any more YA romance. I'm just not into YA anymore. So who knows what that will fill up. This next shelf down is my YA fantasy shelf. So over here we have some books by Cassandra Clare. There's some of the Mortal Instruments and then some from the Infernal Devices. I have not finished either series and I need to. It's on my list. I will get it done. I have this big book, The Chronicles of Narnia. My brother got me for like a birthday gift when I was like 12 or something. Eldest, The Power of Six, all my Harry Potter books. They're in horrible condition. And you know, fun fact, I don't know if this is a fun fact, but I've read all of the Harry Potter books except for The Prisoner of Azkaban, which I'm not sure why. I have no idea why, but yeah. So that's that shelf. It's pretty full. Again, I don't think I will be buying any more YA books, but you never know. I mean, there still are some books by J.K. Rowling, which I have not read, so I might buy those because they're part of the Harry Potter universe, so maybe. So that's that shelf. And then the bottom shelf is kind of like a hodgepodge collection of textbooks from school. All of these right here, these are all my piano books, so my sheet music basically. The Unexplained, which is just like some random book. Art history books, an introduction to art. I even have a cookbook. Rock and Gem. I took a geology class in college, which was super fun. These are my literature anthologies that I had to read for school. Super good stories in here. There's some poems in some of them, but for the most part, it's just like short stories, essays, snippets of books, just like super interesting stuff. So love these books. I will never get rid of them. Plus they were super expensive. This is 501 Great Writers. I bought this super cheap at a used bookstore and it has super interesting stuff. Yeah, so love this book. It has all of the great writers and like a little blurb about them and stuff. Okay, so there's that. I have a little book on the Shedd Aquarium because when I was at Purdue, I took an oceanography class and I live right by Chicago. I'm an hour and a half away from Chicago. So I did a paper on the Shedd Aquarium when I went there. This is a photo album. These are my yearbooks from high school. 2010, 2009, 2008, 2007. This, I used to be obsessed. Like when I was a teenager, I was obsessed with the American flag. Not that I'm not now, but like I was obsessed. Like everything in my room was American flag. So my brother-in-law at the time bought me this. It was like all of our flags that we've ever had in the United States, which is pretty cool. I have a big long book of the World Trade Center. Again, when I was younger, especially when 9/11 happened, it was a topic that I was very interested in. Like I read about it all the time, watched all the documentaries and stuff. And so I wouldn't say I was obsessed with it, but it was something that I always wanted to learn about. So he bought me this book as well. So I still have that. And then I have this really cool 70 years of extraordinary photography from life. Cool book. I got it super cheap at a used bookstore. So there's that shelf. So this is that whole bookshelf. That whole bookshelf. And there's plenty of room for more books. So moving on. Okay, my next bookshelf is one of my little ones. The bottom is completely empty, so still can be filled. The very top. Okay, so this little section of this shelf is for my... These four books are paranormal romance. I only have four. Three of the True Blood series, and then this one, Unchained by Helen Hart, which I'm hating so far, but we'll get to it, I guess. My four books of the Game of Thrones, which I'm a huge fan of Game of Thrones. I'm not all caught up on the books or the show. I've only actually ever read Game of Thrones, and then I started Clash of Kings. Haven't gotten any farther, but I need to. And then this one lonely book, fantasy book. So this is like my little like fantasy, paranormal, adult area. I don't have very many. The next shelf is my historical romance. This is all filled up and it overflows actually a little bit up here. A lot of these books, the ones that I really actually love are these ones by Joanna Lindsay. She's probably my favorite historical romance author. I just love all of her books. I seem to like them all. Usually I don't ever buy these because I read them like so fast and they're like, I don't know. Like I usually get these from the library. But so these that I have, my sister bought these, let me borrow them. I fell in love with them, so she let me have them. So that's why I have these. These big ones, these my aunt sent me and I haven't read yet, but she loves this author, Laverl Spencer. So I need to read her. And then all of these random ones, I can't even tell you. I think like, I definitely bought this one myself because it's Joanna Lindsay. But some of these I think I kind of took from my sister or people gave them to me or just random. Some of these I haven't even read, so. But I love historical romance. That's like my, the genre I read for pure pleasure. Like it is, I usually read these in a day because I love stories. So that's that shelf. So moving on to the next one. Directly to the side of it is my contemporary romance. I don't have as many of these. I have some that I've bought. I have the 50 Shades of Grey. I think the very first one, 50 Shades. I thought I had 50 Shades of Grey. I might have let someone borrow it and then never got it back. These are my contemporary romance. I've read most of these. Like I've read all of these by Nicholas Sparks. I used to be a Nicholas Sparks fan back in the day. Now his books kind of have gotten a little old to me. I'm not as big of a fan. I did love these two, which is why I have them. Dear John and The Last Song. These were really good. Walk to Remember was all right. And The Guardian is my sister's favorite. Then this book, which I loved, is called Stay by Allie Larkin. Super cute book. And yes, I did buy it because there was a dog on the front. Super cute story. Something Blue. So good. This is like part two of Something Borrowed, which they did turn into a movie. The books are great. This is probably my favorite one out of the two stories. It's great. You should read it. It's just good. It's good. So I have those. And then, yeah, nothing much here, but still room. And again, at the bottom, empty. There's nothing there. So the very top is kind of a hodgepodge. These books right here are a lot of like, I kind of call this my reference shelf. There's random stuff. There's like, I have a Spanish dictionary. I have a law dictionary. I have the Blue Book, which is kind of a law thing because I have a paralegal certificate, so I had to get those. The Elements of Style, which every writer should have. I've got some, God, come on, get in there. Okay. I have a few travel books on Italy because I totally want to go there someday. A little dictionary. It's just, these are random little books. But these are from like school, that like theory of the leisure class, how to read literature, asking the right question. A practical introduction to literary studies. So just very, like, I don't know, literature, like, school stuff? I don't know. Then, United States Catholic Catechism for Adults, when I had to get this book and this Bible when I got my communion, which was, I got it a few years ago. I never got it as a kid, and my dream was always to get married in the Catholic Church, to have a Catholic wedding, and you have to have your communion at least. So I was like, well, I gotta do this. So I put myself through this class, and then I got my communion as an adult, which was kind of weird, but whatever. And then another Holy Bible, which I think this was JC's. I don't know. I'm not really, like, religious, hardcore, or anything. I believe in God, but, like, yeah, I feel bad giving away Bibles. So that is this shelf, kind of random. Okay, one of my favorite shelves, which I am dedicating. So this is one of my little three shelf shelves. These are all my classics, which surprised me. In my whole life, I have never sorted my books. Like, I've never, ever had any kind of organization. And this is the first time I do, and I've decided to organize them by genre. And I surprised myself at how many classics I have. I did not think I had this many classics. Like, so clearly I'm a big classics fan. Didn't know. So yeah, these are actually in no order. So this is my top shelf, and it's literally just what would fit. So I have some stuff I had to get for school, like Conjure Tales, which was super interesting. I had to get that for school. Villette, had to read that for school. College, The Importance of Being Earnest. I did not have to... Wait, did I? I can't remember if I had to read that. Lord of the Flies. So some of these, I really love literature and I really love classics. And so that's why I have them. And I have... But there are a good amount that I haven't read yet. Like, I have not read Lord of the Flies. It was never assigned to me when I was in school. I know a lot of people it was, but that's why I bought it, because I want to read it. Huckleberry Finn, I've read a few times. I love this story. It's insane. I actually had to read it for college, so that was super interesting. The Inferno, because I'm obsessed with The Inferno. The Quiet American, I had to read that for a class. I wasn't crazy about it. Heart of Darkness, ugh, that's about colonialism, super depressing. Travels with Charlie by John Steinbeck. I want to read all of John Steinbeck's work, because I love him. Tess of the D'Urbervilles, I want to read this. I haven't read it yet, but I really want to. Fahrenheit 451, I did read this. It was alright. Diary of a Young Girl, oh god, so good. Start of My Life. So I mean, I've got like Dracula, 1984, Far From the Madding Crowd. Had to read that for school. I loved it. Down here, I have my nice version of my The Divine Comedy. Inferno Revealed, which is about, it's kind of like a, one of those books you read that is like about the Divine Comedy. So Inferno Revealed, Dante in Love. I have my Harper Lee books, To Kill a Mockingbird and Ghost at a Watchman. The Grapes of Wrath by John Steinbeck. Haven't read that yet. Paradise Lost by John Milton. Haven't read that yet. The Narrative of the Life of Frederick Douglass. Had to read this for school, and I read it, and it's good. The Alchemist by Paulo Coelho. I did not like this book. I follow him on Twitter. He's totally cool. He's an amazing writer, but I didn't get it. I did not get the whole, like, craziness about this book. Mrs. Dalloway, super good book. I didn't finish the end of it. I don't know why I have a habit of doing that sometimes, but it was good. I need to finish it. To the Lighthouse by Virginia Woolf, need to finish that. Oh, I need to read this. Their Eyes Were Watching God by Zora Neale Hurston, which is why I bought it, because it's one of those books that, like, everyone should read. The Joy Luck Club, I need to read that. Wide Sargasso Sea, I've read this for school. This is super interesting. If anybody is a Jane Eyre fan, this book was written specifically, like, in response to Jane Eyre. So this was written by Jean Rice, I think, or Reese. I can never remember how to properly pronounce her name. But she writes from the perspective of the crazy woman in Jane Eyre, the crazy woman that's upstairs with the crazy hair and that ends up setting fire to the house and stuff. Sorry if you, that's a Jane Eyre spoiler, but this is from her perspective and how she first married Rochester, and it's super interesting. This is a piece of literature. It's super not, I wouldn't say not easy to read, but it's not, I don't know how to explain it, but it's in response to that, and it's super interesting. It totally makes you think, and it puts a whole different spin on the story of Jane Eyre. The Souls of Black Folk. I had to read this for school. Super good. Some Short Stories by Ernest Hemingway. Haven't read those yet. A Farewell to Arms. I read that. Super sad. In Cold Blood by Truman Capote. Oh my god, if you're a true crime fan, read this. It is so good. Watch the movie Capote, because it kind of is about this a little. Super fascinating. It's so good. As I Lay Dying by William Faulkner. I read this. I did not know this was stream of conscious thought, which it is, so it's kind of hard to understand and follow along with. Super weird, but it was good. Like, I get it. So that's good. Slaughterhouse-Five by Kurt Vonnegut. I read this in high school. It was all right. I don't really get it. Another version of Huckleberry Finn. North and South by Elizabeth Gaskell. This is a good book. It is about... I took a literature class in college called Love and Work in 19th Century England, I think. Yes, I think. But it was about... So it's a love story, but it's also about the working class and, like, during that time period. It's super fascinating. Super good. There's also a series, a little, like, mini series on this on Netflix. And it follows it pretty close to a T. Pride and Prejudice by Jane Austen. I just love Pride and Prejudice. So good. Oh. This is the only other book I have by Jane Austen, Northanger Abbey. Haven't read it yet. Moby Dick by Herman Melville. Haven't read that yet. And Anna Karenina by Leo Tolstoy. So I haven't read that. So yeah. Oh gosh, my top shelf. Hello. So yes, that is my classic shelf, and I'm super proud of it, and I'm gonna get more, and I'm gonna read more. I love classics. They're not as easy to read, they're not as easy to get into, and they're rarely ever page turners, but they're good, and they can be good. So yeah, so that's that. And now we're gonna do my last bookshelf on the top. This little section I'm just labeling fiction. This is kind of like stuff that didn't fit anywhere else on my shelves. So it's like a little bit of just fiction. I don't know what else to call it. So yeah, that's what that is. It's a super tiny area. This section is more my nonfiction / biography. Or no, not biography. Right? No, this is like my nonfiction / self-help book area. I don't know. Again, it's kind of random because this is about the Hope Diamond. This is a true story about these two guys. This is kind of a self-help book. This is about this guy who fought demons, basically, and how to win friends and influence people. Like, so it's random. My second shelf down here is all of my journals and my sketchbooks and my coloring books. And yeah, love this shelf. One of my favorites. Okay, now this next shelf is probably one of my favorites, and it's so sad that it's so small, but this is my true crime shelf. I'm a true crime freak, and these are the only true crime books I have, which is super sad. I need to buy more. So yeah, there's that. The next shelf is one of my favorite, is also another one of my favorite shelves. So this little section are my biographies. I have a biography on the Borgias, Marie Curie, Caravaggio, Einstein, and Caligula. I love biographies. I love learning about certain people that are super well known and are fascinating. And these people are super fascinating to me. I definitely am going to get more biographies. I love biographies. Just obviously not anybody, but yeah. So these are those. And then this last little bit, I'm calling my memoirs. I didn't know I had this many memoirs, but I do, I guess. So I have Night by Elie Wiesel, or Eli Wiesel. I don't know how to say his name. This, Traveling to Infinity by Jane Hawking. 7 Years in Tibet, Barefoot Heart, A Small Place by Jamaica Kincaid, Funny and Farsi, Elizabeth Smart, which she totally signed this book. I met her in person. It was so cool. 1,000 Naked Strangers, Brain on Fire, Eat, Pray, Love, I Hope They Serve Beer in Hell, which I'm sure I will probably never read, but JC read it and he loved it. Big surprise. And A Journal for Jordan. So yeah, these are my memoirs. And that's it. Like, look. Empty. I have so many empty shelves, and part of me is like, oh my god, this looks sad, and part of me is just so happy because that means I just can't wait to fill them all up. And I'm sure as I buy more books, I'm definitely gonna give away some books. Like, I really don't even know why I have historical. There's a few of those historical romance that I actually love and I want to keep, but not many. So yeah, those are my bookshelves.
Alright guys, so that was my little bookshelf tour. I hope you enjoyed it. I don't have much right now, but my collection will slowly grow, so I'm happy. I'm happy I finally have my own space, my own personal library, which I've always wanted. Like, that's a dream, and I have it now. And now I can just fill this room up with books, and that makes me happy. So yeah, thank you for watching, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye!